Okay, beta. So as I already told me that it is audible to you all. Fine, let's start. The Portrait of a Lady, written by Khushwant Singh. So I was telling you, you need to remember the name of the writer in this chapter only because it is autobiographical in nature. Khushwant Singh is going to talk about his relationship with his grandmother. How, as a you can say, in his boyhood, what sort of relationship, and in his adulthood, what sort of relationship? Fine. And there is a change, fine, transition, a drastic change was there in all the different stages that we are going to read. So before reading, what do you mean by the word portrait? You might have, it's not portrait. The last E is silent. What do you mean by portrait? Yes, Manjot. As a character sketch. Character sketch. What do you think? In same way. So portrait, otherwise, when it comes to beta drawing skills, there also we know portraits are there. But in this, it is used in wider sense. Portrait here means the, you can say physically as well as the other personality traits of one's character. So that becomes a true portrait, that how the person looks physically when we see him or her, as well as what sort of personality the person is. That is also the true portrait of a person. So that's why the name of the chapter is The Portrait of a Lady. Clear? That how she looks, and brief and very, you know, minute description is given about her hair locks, about her stoop, how she walks, and how she looks serene, as white as mountain. So Khushwant Singh has given time to the physical description of the portrait as well as the qualities also. So let's start with this after knowing the meaning of portrait now. So the Portrait of a Lady by Khushwant Singh, it is general account of his grandmother. So you should know it is account of Khushwant Singh's grandmother. Clear? Fine, the very general point. So now we'll be moving on to different points, because even sometimes I can miss it. I'll be using my book. First of all, we just read about that he has given a lifelike portrait. Lifelike means even if you do not see the person, you can very well imagine it. Fine, when you listen to the description of the person. So it is very life-like portrait. Life-like portrait, fine. The description is very accurate, that you see, that you are seeing the person in front of your eye. Fine, it means life-like portrait. After that, firstly, the physical description of the grandmother. Fine, she was very old, we all know, fine. And she, her face was totally wrinkled. Wrinkled face. Physical description of grandmother, fine. Wrinkled face. And that old, that nobody can believe even that once she was young. Itni budi ho chuki hai. That if you cannot even imagine ki, okay, this lady was once in a time was beautiful. So she has grown so old. Clear? Too old to be believed that once she was young. Clear? Then she was a short-heighted lady. Short lady means short-heighted lady. Fine, her height was not that, she was not tall. She was fat. She was slightly bent. So in the old age, what happens? We sometimes, not all, but many people, they get stooped. So they walk like this, fine. So she was having slightly bent. She was. Clear? This is the, when you get a character sketch, what do you write in a character sketch? Firstly, you describe the physical attributes only. Clear? Short lady, fat, slightly bent. So Anjali, kindly take the attendance side by side. So it's a joint class. Make sure you bifurcate accordingly. Then, after that, beta, one other attribute to her personality, that she keeps on telling the beads of a rosary. Every time when you see her, you can see that she is having a rosary. Fine, that jisko aap mala keh dete ho in Hindi. And you know, people in the that era, they used to believe that whenever we take the name of the God, we should count it the way we are counting the beads. So that in that way, she would change the bead and she would recite the prayers silently. Fine, so that shows she was a very devoted lady, always telling the beads of. This is the physical description, beta. Always telling the beads of rosary in her hand. Fine. Now, after that, writer has described her lips constantly moved in prayer. Never ever in his lifetime he has seen that grandmother was not praying to God. So silent prayer was continuously going on. One can perceive with the movement of her lips. And she would wear white clothes only. White clothes. Always. Fine. Still students are joining. See, they don't know the period is there. Fine. And her silver locks scattered on her pale face. Silver locks means jo uske baal hai wo boodhi ho chuki obviously. So her hair has turned quite whitish silver. So silver locks scattered on her face, always reciting prayers with slightly bent, fine, wearing white, and she looks like mountains. Which devices this simile? We have compared grandmother with mountains, as serene, as beautiful as mountains. Fine, when we go to a natural place, what do we feel? We feel contentment. We feel peace after seeing the mountains and natural beauty. Similarly, when we see the grandmother wearing all white continuously, so she has a personality, you know. Some people have different personality that after meeting them, you do not forget them. Right? So she is that kind of lady. Fine. Always praying to God, telling the beads of rosary and in that way. Fine. So is it clear the physical description? Now we are going to talk about the relationship of Khushwant Singh with his grandmother. That is the base of this chapter. Fine. This is the character sketch. And you're preparing for subjective also. This time this is objective. You can get any question. But next time you will be preparing for subjective also. So you should know both. Clear? So let's talk about, write down. Khushwant Singh and his grandmother were very good friends. You can just write both were very good friends. Short mein apne liye likhna hai aapne. This is your preparation, your notes. Fine. Both were very good friends. Ab aapne pehle likhna hai phase number one. This is the way to remember the things. I'm going to talk about the phases in the life of their relationship. So these phases are based on relationship between both. Clear? Phase one, number one. When author's parents shifted to city. This is the first phase. When author's parents shifted to city. Fine, now what will happen? The whole responsibility comes on the shoulders of grandmother. So being single-handedly, she's going to manage. And let me tell you about the grandfather. He's no more. And his picture is hanging on one of the walls above the mantelpiece. He has long white beard. You should know that also. And he also looks as if a 100-year-old man when in the picture. fine, and as old as one can be. Clear, but he is no more now, and grandmother is single-handedly going to handle this kid. And now this is the phase where both of them will be connecting the best. Fine, because they will be spending their day, night, schooling, everything together. More time they got, fine. So Khushwant Singh, his parents shifted to city, and he was alone in the village with his grandmother, and she was a very good, now we'll be revealing the qualities, a caring grandmother, fine. She was very caring towards her grandson, and she was very loving also. So this is the character sketch. Mainly we are talking about this lady only in the whole chapter, fine. So she was very caring and loving. She took good care of him. She used to wake up him in the morning, fine. And then while making him ready for the school, she would deliberately sing hymns. Fine, hymns means spiritual or religious bhajans or religious songs. And deliberately she would sing so that by listening to her, he would also recite the same song. So that was a deliberate and noble act, fine. So she was trying to imbibe best values in the child, clear? She used to wake him up, make him ready for the school, and then she would say her morning prayer in sing song manner, and then after that preparing him, she would fetch his wooden slate. During those days they were not having pen and paper, wooden slates and ink pots were there. It with help of one wooden pen, every time when you write a word or a letter you need to dip it in the ink. Have you seen it in your lifetime? Kabhi dekha kisi ne? So that was there. So every time you need to write, you need to dip it in the ink, then you write, fine. So she would bring wooden slate. She had already washed it and plastered it with yellow chalk. She would take on an earthen ink pot, fine, an extra pen also, and she would tie them in a bundle and then she would give it to him. It was kind of a bag, school bag, jisko aap keh rahe ho, but school bag was not there. She would tie a bundle of this slate and wooden board and ink pot and all, fine. And after that, that was the fixed routine. She would give him a stale chapati with little butter. You know what we do, people do at night, if any chapati is there, in the morning we throw to the dogs or to the cats, or just we throw in the dustbin. We waste food a lot, we people, I'm saying we, all of us, fine. But that lady, you know, the jo purane log hote hain, they were never ever into this thing. They never used to waste food. Food waste jitna hoga utna hi aapka nuksan hai society ka. So she would keep those stale chapatis raat wali, and she would apply butter and sugar on it, and then she would give it to author Khushwant Singh, fine. Both of them would eat that together, and it was the breakfast, the fixed breakfast for Khushwant Singh. And then after that she would carry several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs also. So that shows her caring nature for animals also, fine. This is the first phase, and still first phase is going on. And when Khushwant Singh would sit in the school, she would sit in the veranda adjoining the school, fine. This was attached, a temple was attached to the school. She would sit there. She would he would sing the alphabet and the morning prayer in the school, fine. And grandmother, she would sit in the temple. She would read the holy books. She was mostly she was spending her time into religious things only, fine. After completion they would walk back home together. And while coming back, remember, not while going to the school, while coming back, they would fetch, they would feed the village dogs with the stale chapatis. Clear? So that was the basic routine. Clear? Now the first phase is over. Clear? Phase one is over. Phase two. So you can see in the phase one, most of time they spent together. Both shifted to city. Parents called them to city. So grandmother and grandson both shifted to city because their parents called them there. After getting settled over there, they sent for Khushwant Singh and their mother. So both of them, they went there. And this is the turning point. Beta, phase two jo hai, this is the turning point in the relation of grandmother and grandson. Fine. Why it is so? Let me tell you that also. They shared the same room in the city, fine. But the thing was that first turning point was that grandmother Now she cannot accompany the author to school because a school bus would come to take him, and he was admitted into an English school where they do not teach about scriptures. They do not teach about holy books. Fine, they do not tell about gods and goddesses, obviously. And in English schools, he was being taught about concepts of science, English language, and music lessons were also given. And now grandmother, she became very disheartened. Why she became disheartened? She thought that music has lewd associations, L-E-W-D. Lewd associations means cheap associations. She thinks that music is meant for such people who are into the poor professions. Fine, but this is not meant for the gentle folks, gentle people. So that's why she was disheartened. That was the first turning point. Yes, author would tell her about his routine, what he learned in the school. They would share the same room and some time, but time lapse now is different. They were spending less time together now. Fine. So this is the turning point, phase number two. That's over. And now one more important thing in phase two, how grandmother channelized herself. She started feeding sparrows now. Earlier she used to feed dogs, but dogs were nowhere to be found in cities. She was in the indoors only. So she started feeding the sparrow. So that was the big change. And she used to spend time by spinning the wheel also. Okay, spinning the wheel and feeding the sparrows. These two things she would do. Now years rolled by, and sometimes she would ask him about the teacher had taught him, and she never believed in this thing and all. And finally, another phase, phase number three, beta, write down, when author went to university. When author shifted to, you went to university. Now author is a grown up, you can say adult, and he's going to university. And finally, he was separated from his grandmother because now he seeks his own privacy. He was given a separate room to reside. Fine. Common link of friendship was there when they used to talk about school. That was broken. Clear? Or time kam ho gaya. Obviously, when you are residing with a person in one room, you will spend time, you will talk to each other. But now author started residing and he became busy in his higher studies also. So common link of friendship was broken. It was snapped. Grandmother, she accepted. That is the very beautiful quality of grandmother, quality of acceptance. She accepted her loneliness. Fine, she did not say anything about it. She accepted the change. But she was always busy in spinning the wheel, in reciting the prayers. She rarely talked to anyone. She became introvert now. You know the three kinds of personalities? Psychology says there are three kinds of personalities. Introvert, extrovert. This is just for your knowledge sake. This has nothing to do with this chapter, but yes, grandmother became introvert. Ye term aapne nahi suni hai. Ambivert. Have you heard about this? So psychology says that there are mainly three kind of people. Firstly, the introvert. Those who do not talk much, wo apne mein hi rehte hain. It doesn't mean that they are not intelligent. Fine, but they like to remain alone, secluded from rest of the people. Unko zyada baat karna pasand nahi hai. Namandeep is introvert. In my class, he does not talk much, but it doesn't mean that he's not intelligent. This is his choice that he wants to be introvert. But he's not at home, he's not at least. Fine, that is in, maybe in society he becomes so. Then there are people who become, they are extroverts, like this boy. He's very talkative. I'm not saying in a bad way. Means you're very social. You know, you talk to easily to with easygoing personality. You talk to anyone. You can be friendly with anyone. You're comfortable with each kind of personality. Third category is ambivert. Ye bahut kam hote hain duniya mein. Ambivert is when there is need to become introvert, they become introvert. When there is need to become extrovert, they become extrovert. Balance the personalities. Okay? Inko ambivert bol dete. This is just for knowledge sake. So we are going to apply that when Khushwant Singh went to university, grandmother stopped talking much. She rarely talked. She became introvert. Clear? Wo zyada baat nahi karti thi kisi se. Yes, children. Is it clear? Online children, I'm asking you. 29 children are there. Getting my point? Diya, am I audible? Fine, beta. So, finally, narrator went to university. She was alone. She started spinning the wheel, reciting prayers, did not talk to anyone. And in the afternoon, after relaxing for a while, she would feed the sparrows. And what did she feed the sparrows? Breadcrumbs. Fine, chote chote breadcrumbs banake, she would feed the sparrows. And she would sit in the veranda at that time. And hundreds of sparrows would come. And even, you know, animals and birds, they do understand the language of love. They do not understand Punjabi, English, Hindi. They understand the language of love. When they realize that this human being is to help us, they will come near to you without harming you. Fine. So sparrows would sit on her head, on her shoulders, along on in the veranda, and they would enjoy the breadcrumbs. So that was the daily routine. And they created a hell of a noise. Chirping sounds were there all the time and she was feeding them. Fine. Even some used to sit on her legs. Others would sit on the shoulders, on head and all. And she never shooed them away. Grandmother was smiling only always. And that was the best half an hour of her the whole day. Fine. That she loved feeding others. Half an hour ke liye. Remember for MCQs. That was half an hour only. Fine. The narrator decided to go abroad for higher studies. Another phase after the university, fourth phase came. He decided that I have to go to abroad now. And for 5 long years. And grandmother, you know that already she's very old. Fine. And you never know whether he'll be able to receive her at the other end or not. She was depressed. She was dejected. But she never showed her emotion to anyone. She even came to, you know, bid goodbye to him at the railway station, but she just did not shed any tear, did not show any emotion. But it does not mean jo log emotions nahi dikhate hain, wo emotional nahi hai. Again, we are mistaken here. Fine, in her heart of hearts, aur zyada problem hoti hai. You know, they are in trouble. The people who do not give vent to their feelings, the people who do not express their feelings, unko or depression ho sakta hai. One should cry also at the time of crying. And boys also, I always say, and you know, there is one ad that boys rote nahi hai. Or that is to teach us, kyun nahi rote hai? It is human part. When we are unhappy, we should cry. And ab ghar ja ke rone mat baith jana. I'm just giving you example that when there is need to cry, one should cry. This is giving vent to one's emotions. Okay? Jab aapko khush hona hai, khush hoiye. Don't try to snub your feelings. अपनी feelings को छुपाना नहीं है, दबाना नहीं है. जितना suppress करोगे, that will be very harmful to your own personality. Clear? So she did not show any emotion. That is not a good sign. She just kissed on the forehead of author. That was the last physical touch between the both. Fine. हम जैसे-जैसे बड़े होते जाते हैं, हम क्या करते हैं? हम अपने parents से physically दूर हो जाते हैं. You know, when you were a kid, you remember how you used to hug your father and mother, parents also. And now you are hesitant. Why should I do hug to my mother? And you should give. Why not? Why not? I'm asking. If you are an adult, why not show your love physically? Sons and daughters both. Fine. So this is your right to express your love. One should express one's love towards parents, especially. Towards grandparents also. Fine, but we are hesitant. So she was not showing and she just kissed on the forehead and moist impression was left on his forehead. And that time Khushwant Singh was thinking that maybe I'm meeting my grandmother for the last time. But it was not so. Clear? After 5 years when he came back, he was happy to know that grandmother, she came to receive grandson at the railway station. After 5 years, she looked the same. Fine. When he was as a child also, she looked the same. Kuch logo ki physique aise hi hoti hai. But even after 10 years, you see them, they look same only. So she was one of those kinds. Fine. And when he came, what unusual thing happened that day? When author returned from abroad, she held him in her arms. Fine. But she kept on reciting her prayers. In the afternoon, she fed the sparrows also. But in the evening, when author returned, in that evening, there was a change in her behavior. And that was a drastic change. She did not pray. The lady who prays for continuously so many hours, she did not pray at all. Clear? And that was quite strange thing. Clear? So what she did, another strange thing happened. She collected women from the neighborhood and she started beating the drum that she had never done earlier. Fine. So this is very eccentric behavior, very strange behavior. Fine. And she started beating the drums and she is not having the caliber or strength to do so, being at such age. And after that, what happened? She got an old drum. She continued thumping for several hours. She started singing also. Why did she do so? Why did she do? Yes, actually, this is one emotion to it. She was not talkative, na? She was with their, have you seen an animal? Dogs hai sabke paas jab aap ghar jaate ho, how they wag their tail. Dogs kya karte hain? They start wagging their tail, they start jumping on you, they start licking you. That is their way of expression. Unko samajh mein nahi aata, woh bhagna shuru kar dete hain dogs idhar udhar. Those who have dogs, they know that. Fine. So this is their way of expressing the love. So she was so happy that she started beating the drums and she started singing the songs. Particular category of singing of warriors when they come back after winning the battle. ठीक है, शादियों में कुछ गाने होते हैं वो अलग होते हैं, कुछ कहते हैं उनको पंजाबी में, I don't remember what. But when warriors after winning the battles they come back, so there are particular songs related to that. She started singing those songs. It means she was very happy that my grandson has come back. And after that she became very tired. Fine. Next morning she became very ill as a result. She did not want to talk to anyone. It'd be waste of time. She ignored requests of everyone. She kept on lying peacefully in the bed. She kept on reciting the prayer. Last day usne prayers bhi nahi kari thi. Fine. So she was holding the rosary. She was telling the beads. Suddenly her lips stopped moving. And suddenly rosary fell from her fingers. And a paleness could be seen on her face. And she died peacefully. Now you tell me why she died that next day when author came back. You know, when we are really connected to people, it means she had, maybe she was waiting for this. She was so much in love after her husband's death. What was there? Grandparents ke liye kya hai? The life is grandchildren only. They have, you know, there should be someone to look up to. So for grandparents especially, how many of you have grandparents at home? So what I'm asking, even my grandfather is there, is 90 or 90 plus. What they want from you? Do they ask for money? Do they ask for some new branded dress? They just want our time. That 5 minutes aap baith ke unse, humare paas 5 minutes bhi nahi hai. Okay, we should spend quality time with them. We should sit with them. We should talk to them. Just ask about how are you feeling. Talk about any issue. Aapko pata hota hai unka interest kis mein hai. Fine, talk about that topic or just give 5 minutes. You never know when next moment when you are not going to see them, then you will miss them. Fine. So whosoever, I'm not talking about grandparent, whosoever is there in your life, loved ones, spend quality time with them. Or hum kisko impress karne mein lage hue? To the society on social media. This is what we are doing. We are not understanding the true reality lies in our own family. Spend time with them rather than spending time with the ones who do not even bother about your life. Fine. So she was so happy. She was so concerned, connected to grandson. Then after his arrival only she died, not before. Her soul was connected to him. So it was the evening time. So her body was laid on ground. She was covered with a red shawl. Arrangements for the funeral ceremony was made. It was the evening time. Sun was setting. Light was entering the place where her body was kept. And that day when her body was being carried away, at that time, same time when sparrows would come, birds did come, but they did not, you know, and author's mother now, not grandmother, author's mother thought that sparrows have come to have their crumbs only. she also broke bread into crumbs and she tried to feed them. She just the way grandmother used to scatter, but not a single bird took notice of the breadcrumb. That means birds do understand also the situations. When her body was taken away for funeral, all the sparrows just they flew away without taking notice of the breadcrumbs. That show that grandmother was deeply attached with her grandson. Firstly, she was deeply attached with the animals in the village, dogs in the village, and sparrows in the city. Clear? So that shows that birds were not there to have meal. They were there to express their sorrow. And how did they express their sorrow? By eating the crumbs, by not eating the crumbs. And they did not make any, they did not create any noise also that day. Otherwise, there was a lot of chaos and noise. Fine? So that shows evidently the sparrows had come to mourn the death. M-O-U-R-N. Mourning means death mein jo rote hain, that way to express the sorrow. Fine, is it clear to all of you? Any doubt? So, aapko beta jo questions hai, isme fact nahi hai koi bhi. Is chapter mein MCQs jaise fact based nahi hai. But you can get intricate question that what did grandmother hate about schools? Learning of social sciences, learning of sciences, learning of English and music, both B and C. Answer is? मैंने खुद इन्वेंट किया है अभी मेरे को खुद नहीं याद है. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग व्हाट डिड ग्रैंडमदर डिड नॉट लाइक अबाउट सिटी स्कूल्स. ऑप्शन ए लर्निंग ऑफ सोशल साइंसेस. ऑप्शन बी लर्निंग ऑफ साइंसेस. ऑप्शन सी लर्निंग ऑफ म्यूजिक एंड ऑप्शन डी लर्निंग ऑफ इंग्लिश. Especially she believed that music had lewd associations. She did not like it, but it can be other way also, confusing way also. Clear? Okay, so have a nice day.